Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Amen. It's good morning. We even have a little bit of snow on the ground to remind us it's winter. And somebody said, boo. I agree. But anyway, it is what it is. We're not too far away from spring, so that's a good thing. we extend a special welcome to anybody who's here for the first time. We're very, very glad you're here. We just want to welcome you. And just make yourself at home and just open up your heart to God, because he wants to make a big difference in your life this morning. Amen. We are privileged for the first time to have Jason and Sarah Fath and their family. I had never heard the name Fath before, so I asked him, I said, so what nationality is that? And he said, it's French. So I love to find out backgrounds of names. Names fascinate me, and we all come from such diverse backgrounds. It's fun to see how God brings us together. And so we're at a regional retreat for our ministerial association that we're a part of, my wife and I. And the regional director introduced Jason and had him come up and talk, and I just had a stirring in my heart that we were supposed to have him in. We haven't had a real evangelist in for a long time, and because there's just not a lot of them out there, and or at least ones that I would consider worthy to come in here. And but I just really had a strong stirring, and so we're just really privileged. They're from Colfax, am I right? Colfax, Iowa, just about 20 miles outside of Des Moines, and so they came up here, and we did evangelism training yesterday, and that was marvelous and wonderful, and so he's going to minister today. So, you know, praise God, open up your heart, because God is going to change your life for the better.
Amen.
Amen. So let's welcome Jason Fath, and then he's going to introduce his wife, who's going to bring a song for us as well. So let's welcome Jason Fath.
Hey. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Praise the Lord. Well, it's an honor and a privilege to be here, and I want to let you know that we love you, we appreciate you, and would like to introduce my wife and maybe my kids here too. This is my wife, Sarah. You can go ahead and stand up, babe, and then go ahead and stand up, DJ. It's my son, DJ, and then my daughter, Analia, is sinking down in the seat. So, but she's 5 years old. I have another daughter and son back in the nursery. My oldest daughter is 15, and my son, Josiah, is a year and a half old. So we're just honored to be here. We love you guys. We appreciate you. And I just want you to get ready to receive from God. You know, God, he's good all the time, right? And he won't withhold any good thing from you this morning because of his blood, right? We're healed by the stripes of Jesus, and we're healed by his blood and his grace and his mercy. And you may not be exactly perfect or living perfect, but that doesn't disqualify you from being blessed by God and him showing you that he's real and that he loves you. Before my wife gets up to minister, I just wanted to make mention of a few things. DJ will be at the book table at the end of the service. We have some stuff back there. So if you want some of that, you can check that out. I'll maybe say more about that later. At this point, I'd like to introduce my beautiful wife, Sarah. She's going to come to the stage, and I would invite you to just enter into the presence of God. If you want to sit, if you want to stand, if you want to lift your hands, whatever you do, want to do, just go ahead and do it. Amen.
Continue in an attitude of worship.
Yes.
Amen.
For this is a test.
Amen. Can everybody say amen?
Amen.
Can everybody say God is good?
God is good.
All the time?
All the time.
He is good.
He is good.
Praise the Lord. Man, it's just an honor and a privilege to be here this morning. I just want you to get ready to receive from God. You know, whatever you came in here with, just get ready to receive because He's got your answer, right? Amen. If I could just, before I get into my message, if I could just get you to raise your hand. If you brought somebody this morning and they came with you, just slip your hand up. Amen. We got a few people slipping their hands up. All right. Praise the Lord. If we could turn in our Bibles to Mark chapter 5. Mark chapter 5, this is a familiar portion of Scripture for a lot of us. One of my favorite passages in the Bible. And this is the account of the woman with the issue of blood. And I believe that many people in many places, and even in my own life at times, we all can relate to the woman with the issue of blood in one way or another. You know, she found herself in a desperate situation. She found herself in need. And she found herself looking for help, going to different places, not being able to get help. You know, and you may find yourself in a similar situation like that this morning. Maybe you have pain or sickness in your physical body. Maybe you have pain in your heart and your mind and your emotions that you need freedom from. And, you know, maybe you don't know Jesus. Maybe you knew Jesus at one time and you're not living for the Lord, but in all of those cases, that's a desperate situation because the Bible talks about those who don't know the Lord as their personal Lord and Savior. They're lost. They're in darkness. And the thing that I love about the woman with the issue of blood and that whole story is that she didn't stay in her desperate situation. And what I want to tell you this morning is whatever desperate situation you find yourself in, you don't have to stay there. You can get freedom, just like the woman with the issue of blood. So let's start reading in Mark chapter 5 and verse 25. Mark 5:25, it says, a woman who had had a hemorrhage for many years, for 12 years, I believe the King James Bible says 12 long years. You know, when you've had sickness or pain in your body, sometimes it's like it kind of makes time stand still and things just seem like they're dragging on. Have you ever been in a situation like that where it's like, is this ever going to get over? The Bible, the King James says 12 long years. She had had a hemorrhage of blood. And then verse 26, it says, and it endured much at the hands of many physicians. Now, thank God for doctors and that they can help you, but I'm sure a lot of us have been in that situation where it seems like, you know, you just get poked and prodded and you endure things, go through kind of things, and you're hoping that it helps you. But maybe it does, maybe it doesn't. Sometimes the medications and treatments they have do more damage to your body than good. And it's the same way 2,000 years later. This woman had endured much at the hands of many physicians. And the Bible says, and she had spent all that she had. Now, it's one thing to go to the doctor and spend some money, or even in this woman's case, spend every last dime you've got and get some help. But this woman spent all that she had and she didn't get any better. She didn't even kind of maintain. The Bible says that she grew worse. Verse 26, and endured much at the hands of many physicians and had spent all that she had and was not helped at all, but rather grew worse. And then in verse 27, it says, after hearing about Jesus, everybody say she heard about Jesus. Man, I'm so glad. I'm so thankful that she heard about Jesus. And I suspect that some of you here this morning, you're here because you heard about Jesus. Amen. It says, after hearing about Jesus, she came up in the crowd. She heard about something. And then she came somewhere to check it out, right? She heard, hey, Jesus is healing people. And they said, let's check this out. Let's go see what's happening. After hearing about Jesus, she came up in the crowd behind him and touched his cloak, for she said, everybody say she said, if I just touch his garments, I will get well. Everybody say, if I just touch his garments, I will get well. You know, she said something to herself. She said, self, I'm going to get up from this desperate situation. I'm going to go find Jesus, and I'm going to touch the hem of his garment, and I'm going to get well. Well, you, just like the woman with the issue of blood, could say to yourself, and I admonish you to do so this morning, say to yourself, self, I'm going to touch the hem of his garment. I'm going to receive what I need from the Lord. Hallelujah. Everybody say hallelujah. Amen. In verse 29, it says, and immediately the flow of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Man, that is awesome. Isn't that awesome? She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. It wasn't like, you know, she just said, well, I'm just taking it by faith, right? Well, thank God for taking it by faith. But something immediately happened right there on the spot. She was instantly healed. She felt something change in her body. Glory to God. Woo! Glory to God immediately. Hallelujah. Did you know you don't have to wait to receive? You can receive right now, right here. Glory to God. Immediately something changed in her body. Everybody say immediately. She felt a change in her body. Hallelujah. Get ready for the suddenlies, for the immediatelies of God. Get ready to feel a change in your body this morning, a change in your heart, a change in your mind, a change in your emotions, a change in your life. If you don't know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior, I'm telling you that's the best decision that you could ever make in your life. There was a time in my life where I wasn't with the Lord, and it was like I was sitting in a dark room. And I was in darkness, and I was lost. But then I said, yes, Jesus, I surrender to you. And as if someone flipped the light on. Woo, glory to God. I was no longer depressed. I was no longer sad. I was no longer looking to fulfill myself with the sinful pleasure of this world. But I found out that there's joy in the presence of the Lord. And at his right hand, there are pleasures forevermore. I found out what the Bible says is true, that sin is pleasurable for a season, but the end result is death. And I had had enough of death. I wanted to experience the life of God. I wanted to have peace and I wanted to have joy. And I found out that the only place that can be found is in Jesus Christ. Woo, hallelujah. Making Jesus Lord of your life is the best thing that you could ever do. He wants you to be saved not only for eternity, but here in this life so you can live for him. He wants you saved, spirit, soul, and body. Glory to God. Everybody say glory to God. I want you to think to yourself, what is your situation this morning? What kind of situation do you find yourself in? And I want you to know, whatever situation you find yourself in, you don't have to stay in that desperate situation. You're getting up and you're getting out of that situation. Your desperate situation does not need to be your destination. Everybody say amen. 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 Now, you know, it's one thing for me to stand up here and tell you that God wants you healed and he wants, you know, to live in your heart and live in your life and heal your mind and your emotions and everything of that nature. It's one thing for me to stand up here and tell you that, but what does the Bible say? My testimony is one thing, but there's somebody else's testimony who is greater than my testimony or any testimony that you could hear from anybody, and that is the testimony of God's written word. The Bible says in 2 Timothy 3:16 that all scripture is given by inspiration of God. It's profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, and instruction in righteousness, that the man of God may be thoroughly equipped for every good work. The Word of God also says in Psalms 119:89, forever, O Lord, your word is settled in heaven. God spoke it, and that means it's good. Can I get an amen? Amen. Psalms 138:2 says that God has exalted his word even above his name. That's just a modern day way of saying that if his word's no good, then his name's no good. I'm here to tell you this morning that the name of Jesus is good. That every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. His name is good because his word is good. And you know, God isn't like some folks. I've known some folks to give you their word and say, yeah, you know, I'm going to do this or I'm going to do that. And then they never show up to do it. And then, you know, after a while, when someone says they're going to do something and then they don't do it, pretty soon you just figure out that their word's no good, and every time their name comes up, it doesn't leave a good taste in your mouth. God's not like that. His word is good and his name is good because he watches over his word to perform it. Can I get an amen? Amen. Hallelujah. So what does the Bible say? The Bible says in Isaiah 53:5, by the stripes of Jesus, we were healed. Jesus took stripes upon his back for you, for your healing. And in that passage, it's not only talking about physical healing for your body, it's also talking about healing for your mind. It says the chastisement of our peace was upon him. Can I get an amen? Hallelujah. Galatians 3:13 says, Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law, having become a curse for us, for it is written that cursed is everyone that hangeth upon a tree. Did you know Jesus became a curse for you so you wouldn't have to live under a curse anymore? You know, when you're in pain and sickness, sometimes you just feel like it's a curse. It might even make you want a curse because you don't like it. We don't like it. You don't have to live under the curse anymore. Hallelujah. Romans 8:39 says this, what shall separate us from the love of God? Neither trouble, nor persecution, nor danger, nor nakedness, nor sword. But in all of these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. I'm just telling you what God's will is, what his word says about you and what he wants for you. Did you know that word nakedness in that verse, it says that not even nakedness can separate us from the love of God. That goes back to the Garden of Eden. When Adam and Eve were in the garden, they had sinned and they were naked and ashamed. So God is saying, even in his word, even your nakedness, even your shame, even your mistakes cannot separate you from God's love. Whew, man, that's so good, isn't it? I'm telling you this morning that he loves you more than you could ever know or understand. Psalms 103, verses 2 through 5 says this, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all of his benefits, who forgives all your iniquities. I'm so glad it said that he forgives all my iniquities. He forgives all your iniquities. Some people walk around with the attitude and the feeling in their heart and their mind that, you know, maybe they have some of their sins forgiven, but not all of them. Got their head down, walking like, well, I just feel guilty. Well, guess what? All of your iniquities are forgiven. Glory to God. And then it says, who heals all your diseases. I did a word study on that, and it was the most complicated word study I ever did. And I looked that word all up in the Greek, and I found out that the word all means all. Just kidding. It was probably the easiest word study I ever did. The word all means all. It says that he heals all of your diseases. He doesn't leave one out, not 99.9% of your sickness or your disease, but all of them. Woo! Glory to God. Man, God is good. Then it says, who redeems your life from destruction. When you don't know Jesus, your life is on a path headed for destruction. The Bible says the wages of sin is death. And when you're living in sin, you're going to be reaping those wages that you're sowing. And it'll just seem like your life is falling apart. The Bible says in Ephesians, do not be drunk with wine, for that is dissipation, but be filled with the Spirit. That word dissipation means like disintegration. And it's a picture of as if you were boiling a pot of water on a stove. That pot of water is boiling, and then the steam rises from that water, and the steam dissipates into the atmosphere. It says, do not be drunk with wine, for that is dissipation or disintegration. You know, those things can cause your life to fall apart, but it says, but be filled with the Spirit. When you know Jesus, the Spirit of God becomes to live on the inside of you. Everybody say amen. Man, I've seen God do some amazing things. I've seen God heal blind eyes, open deaf ears, just things that would make your mind go tilt. And I want to let you know that if God did it for others, He'll do it for you. And I'm reminded of a time when I was out street witnessing. I had just gotten married to my beautiful wife, Sarah. And you guys know that when you get married, your family expands. Your family grows. So I inherited a new father and mother-in-law and a new brother-in-law. And my brother-in-law, Robbie, had seen some of the things that I was posting on Facebook. And he came to me and he said, hey, Jason, you know, I've never really seen anybody get healed like right there on the spot. I've heard about it, but I've never really seen it. And I'd like to see that. Can I go out and do street witnessing with you? And I said, sure, Robbie, no problem. We met every Friday night at a place called Panera Bread. We'd use their meeting room because we could get it for free, you know, maybe buy a bowl of soup or something and do teaching on evangelism and then go out to different places and share the gospel with people. So we met on a Friday night. Robbie came with me and we went to Walmart. And we went out and told people about Jesus, and people got healed. And Robbie said, man, that was awesome. That was so cool. I said, yeah. And he goes, hey, can I invite my friend Joe next week? I think he would really like to come. And so I said, sure, absolutely. So the following week, we met at Panera Bread, and Joe came along with him. Joe was his best friend. We did our teaching on evangelism and little worship time, and then we went out to evangelize. And we were walking through the double doors of Walmart on 73rd Street in West Des Moines, Iowa. I wouldn't expect that you know where that's at, but that's where we were at. We walked through the double doors of Walmart, and as we're walking through the double doors of Walmart, I'm standing right here, Joe's right here, my brother-in-law Robbie's right here. We're walking through the double doors of Walmart, and Joe looks at me and he says, Jason, I remember this guy who used to come up to me at the Warren County Fair and at the mall and tell me about Jesus. And as we're walking, I'm thinking, I'm like, wait, those are all the same places that I used to go and witness at. And I looked at Joe and I said, Joe, I think that might have been me. And he said, Jason, you know what? You're right. That was you. And I'm like, wow, small world. He said, yeah, that was you. And he said to me, do you remember what you told me that night, like 6 years ago? And I said, Joe, I got to be honest with you. I don't remember what I told you. And then when he told me what I told him when I was out witnessing and ministered to him out on the street, he said, you told me, I've got one question for you. And if it's not you, you're not the person I'm looking for. But did you just get in trouble with the law tonight? And when he said that, it jogged my memory. And I thought, oh, yeah, I remember that. I told my pastor about that one. That was a good one. And so I said, yeah, I remember that. And then it jogged my memory. 6 years prior, before I had gotten married, I was leading the evangelism outreach at my church, at Destiny Bible Church in Indianola, Iowa. And I was having a hard time getting people interested in actually wanting to go out and tell people about Jesus. And so I said, God, I know you've called me to do this, so I'll just do it by myself. So I showed up at the church by myself. I had a key to the church, and I spent time praying in spirit and getting myself ready. And the church was right next door to Walmart in Indianola, which is a different city. That's where the church was at. It was right next to Walmart. And as I was praying, I felt like the Holy Spirit is impressing upon me that I would run into somebody that night who had just gotten in trouble with the law. So I walked myself up to Walmart. Didn't even have to get in the car to go to Walmart because it's right next door. I walked up to Walmart, started walking through Walmart, praying in the Spirit, asking the Lord to show me who it was. And I walked up to Joe. He He was standing by a cart with this older lady, which was his grandmother. I walked up to him and I said, "Hey, my name's Jason. I just want to let you know that God loves you. Can I ask you a question? If this isn't you, then you're not the person I'm looking for. But did you just get in trouble with the law tonight?" And his head went down. He said, "Yeah, man, I did. I just got out of cuffs 30 minutes ago for shoplifting at Walmart." And his grandma was there to pick him up and take him home. And he was lucky he didn't get put in jail. But so I said, "Well, I was praying about it, and I felt like I was going to run into you. And I want you to know that God loves you and he cares about you." I prayed with him to rededicate his life to the Lord. So fast forward. 6 years later, I get married. This guy is best friends with my brother-in-law. We're going through the double doors of Walmart in a different city looking to tell people about Jesus. And we ran into this group of about seven teenagers from a Catholic high school in Des Moines. And I began to tell them about Jesus, share the gospel with them. And one of the girls piped up and said, "Oh, man, you know, we get enough of that from our religion teacher." And I said, "Well, wouldn't you just at least want to pray and ask Jesus into your heart?" And they said, "Nah, we get enough of that from our religion teacher." And then one of the girls said, "Man, you're sure a lot better than our religion teacher." I said, "I'm not trying to be better than your religion teacher. I'm just telling you what the Bible says." And something rose up on the inside of me. I said, "These teens, they need to know Jesus. I can't just let them go like this." So I just began to tell them, "You know, if any of you have pain in your body, I can pray for you and God can heal you." I've prayed for a guy in Ashtabula, Ohio, who was totally blind in his right eye. I've seen God heal all kinds of people. And one of the young men spoke up, and I could tell just by the way that he was saying it that he didn't really believe that he was going to get healed. He was just saying it to challenge me so that he thought that he wasn't going to get healed and he could kind of, you know, make me look dumb and make himself look good in front of the girls. I could just tell by the way he was saying it. I said, "All right, what do you need prayer for?" He said, "Well, I injured my back in football." I said, "Does it hurt right now?" He said, "Yeah, it hurts right now." I said, "All right, I don't even have to lay hands on you. I'll just point to it in the name of Jesus." I said, "In the name of Jesus, back be healed, pain go now in Jesus' name." I said, "Go ahead, bend over, do something you couldn't do before." He bent over and he said, "Dude, wow, that doesn't hurt anymore." And then I said to all the teen girls and everybody in the group, "Look, God just healed your friend because he loves you." And I mean, he was in pain and all of a sudden he's healed. So I prayed with all of them to ask Jesus into their heart at that point. And now my brother-in-law, Robbie's kind of freaking out. And he's like, "Man, dude, that was awesome. That was awesome. We got to pray for Joe's back. Joe's got a bad back." And I'll just to be honest with you, at that time, we had been out for a while, and it had been a while since I had eaten, and I was tired and hungry, and I wanted to go home and be with my new beautiful wife and watch something on Netflix and eat a bowl of ice cream. My flesh is telling me, "Jason, get out of here and go home." I didn't feel spiritual. I didn't feel, quote-unquote, anointed. I said, "All right, we'll pray for Joe's back." I put my hand on his back. I said, and then all he told me was, "Joe's got a bad back." That's all I knew. I put my hand on his back. I said, "Back, be healed right now in the name of Jesus. Flexibility, be restored." I said, "Joe, go ahead and bend over. Do something you couldn't do before." So he bent over and touched his toes, and Robbie came unglued. He said, "Oh my goodness, Joe can't do that." I said, "What do you mean, Robbie? He just did." He said, "Joe can't," and Joe said, "No, Jason, you don't understand, I can't do that." I said, "Go ahead and do it again." "Yeah, you can." So he bent over again and touched his toes. And Robbie and Joe said, "No, you don't understand, Joe had surgery. I had surgery in the seventh grade to correct scoliosis. And I haven't been able to bend over and touch my toes since the seventh grade. Since the seventh grade, he had a curved spine, and he couldn't bend any farther than to touch his knees. He went all the way down and touched his toes. And Robbie said, "Joe, show him the scar on your back." So Joe pulled his shirt up, turned around, pulled his shirt up all the way, and he had a scar that went from the base of his neck all the way down to the bottom of his back, where they cut his back open and put two steel rods on either side of his spine to correct scoliosis. He said, dude, my mind is blown. I have not been able to bend and touch my toes since the seventh grade. Man, isn't that, God is amazing. What I want to tell you this morning is that if God did that for Joe, he'll do it for you. Amen. The Bible says in James chapter 2, my brothers, as believers in our glorious Lord Jesus Christ, don't show favoritism. Amen. And it goes on, even in that chapter, it says, if someone comes into your meeting wearing a gold ring and fine clothes, and you say to that person, here's a good seat for you, but a poor man in shabby clothes also comes in, and you say, here, you can sit on the floor by my feet. It says, have you not become judges with evil thoughts in your hearts? Now, if God, in the Word, says that we aren't to show partiality based upon where we get to sit in church, how much more would it be wrong for God to say, hey, I'll heal one, but I won't heal another? No, Jesus died for all. He paid the price for all. He took stripes upon his back for all. And he loves you. And if he did it for Joe, he'll do it for you. Everyone say, if he healed Joe, he'll heal me. I want you to know this as well. The Bible says, believers shall lay hands on the sick, and the sick shall recover. Jesus said in John 14, 12, he that believeth upon me, the works that I do, he shall do also, and even greater works than these shall he do. Raise your hand if you believe in Jesus. Amen. We got a room full of people who believe in Jesus. Well, that means, according to John 14, 12, that you're qualified, called, appointed, and anointed to do the works of Jesus. Jesus got people healed, and God can use you to do the same. Believers shall lay hands on the sick. I want you to lift your hands up, look at your hands, and say, there's power, healing power of God in my hands. I shall lay hands on the sick, and they shall be made well. Woo! Glory to God! Amen! Hallelujah. Everybody say this. When hands are laid upon me, the healing power of God will go into my body and I'll be healed. Woo! Glory! Hallelujah. Oh man, God is so good. I'm reminded of another time I was ministering in Georgetown, Ohio, for a gentleman by the name of Dale Confer. He was an usher that I ushered with at Rhema when I ushered there. And he was starting a church at the time. And we were just newly traveling on the road, ministering in different places, newly married, my wife and I. And there was this lady that came into the service by the name of Cindy Klein, and I don't know how she heard about the service. Maybe she saw something on Facebook or something like that. But she said that she just felt like she needed to come, and that the Lord told her that she would come, that God would heal her eyes. And she had blurry vision from glaucoma. And so she came up in the prayer line, and I said, hey, how you doing? She said, I'm fine, but I have blurry vision in my eyes. And I said, all right, well, go ahead and take your glasses off. So she took her glasses off. I put my hands on her eyes. I said, in the name of Jesus, eyes be healed, vision be restored right now in Jesus' name. I said, now tell me, what do you see? And she said, I can see a little bit better. And then I laid my hands on her again. I said, in the name of Jesus, eyes be healed, vision be restored. Took my hands off of her eyes. I said, tell me, what do you see? She said, I can see everything perfectly clear, perfectly fine. She went back and sat down in her seat, and she shared a healing testimony afterwards. And in the healing video testimony she shared, she said that she was sitting behind a gentleman who had his arm around his wife, and she was about 10 feet away, and she could read the time on his watch from that far away. So she's like, man, I know it's totally healed. God has totally blessed it. Healed by the power of God. Everybody say amen.
Amen.
Everybody say, if he healed Cindy, he'll heal me. Everybody say, when hands are laid upon me, the healing power of God will go into my body and I'll be healed. Now everybody lift your hands up again and say, the healing power of God is in my hands. I shall lay hands on the sick and they shall be made well. Woo! Glory to God! Thank you, Father. I'm reminded of another time that we were doing a series of meetings in Des Moines, Iowa, at one of their senior centers. This was a senior center that was close to where Sarah and I lived at the time. We lived with our parents after we got married and was saving up our money to get our own place. So I was jogging through the neighborhood, and this place I had jogged through, seen it 100 times, and the Holy Spirit told me, go check that place out to do a meeting. It was a community center, Southside Senior Center. I checked it out, and we started doing these series of meetings called Four Nights of Healing and Miracles. The reason we called them Four Nights of Healing and Miracles is because we could only get the senior center for free 4 nights out of every quarter. So we called them Four Nights of Healing and Miracles. And there was a lady that came to, there was tons of people that were healed. But this one particular testimony that I'm going to share with you, this lady by the name of Susie Clint, I hadn't seen her in probably 20 years. Her son and I went to the same youth group together. She used to go to the same church that I went to when I was younger. And she probably saw something or heard something again on Facebook, and she came to the meeting, and she came up for prayer when we gave the opportunity for people to come up for prayer. I said, hey, Susie, how you doing? I said, it's good to see you. And she's like, oh, it's good to see you too, Jason. I said, what do you need prayer for? And she said, well, I've got pain in my back, and I've been to 6 different doctors. And I actually went to the 6th doctor today, and they said that there's nothing that can be done for my back. They can't do surgery on it. I'm just going to have to live with the pain. I've got degenerative discs in my back. And I said, well, Susie, let me ask you a question. Do you believe that God is able to heal you? And she said, well, of course I believe God can do it. And that's kind of a no-brainer, right? I mean, he created the universe, put the stars in the sky, you know, healing somebody's back would be like kind of like popping a pimple for God. Not too hard. I mean, you know, not too hard. It's like, oh, you know, oh, yeah. She said, yeah, I believe God can do it. And then I said, Susie, let me ask you another question. Do you believe that God wants you to be healed right now? And she said, well, I'm not for sure, Jason. I've been prayed for so many times by different people and I haven't gotten healed that I think maybe I'm doing something wrong. You know, maybe I'm not going to church enough or reading my Bible enough. And I stopped her right there and I said, Susie, God's not going to heal you based upon your ability to earn or deserve a healing any more than he would heal you based upon your ability to earn or deserve salvation. You can't earn or deserve your salvation. Jesus paid the price for your salvation, and he also paid the price for your healing. You may not have been reading your Bible as much as you should or going to church as much as you should, but that's not what qualifies you to be healed. I said, God loves you, he's not mad at you, and he wants you to be healed right now. And my wife and I laid hands on her. I said, I'm going to pray for you, and the healing power of God's going to go into your back, and you're going to be healed, okay? She said, all right. So we laid hands on her back. I said, the name of Jesus, back be healed now in Jesus' name. Pain go, discs be healed. I looked at her, and I said, Susie, Go ahead and bend over, you're healed. She looked back at me and she said, no, I don't want to, it's gonna hurt. I said, no, it's not, you're healed in Jesus' name, bend over. She bent over and touched her toes and she was like, came up with kind of this shocked look, and I said, go ahead and bend over. Do it again, Susie. She bent over, touched her all the way, and she came up with tears streaming down her face. Her back was just totally, instantly healed by the power of God, by the love of God. Amen. Sometimes you just can't take no for an answer. Woo, glory to God. Hallelujah. The Bible says in Hebrews 13:8 that Jesus Christ is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He hasn't changed. Amen. If he healed people in Bible days, he's still doing it today. In 1 Corinthians 15:17, it says, if Christ has not been risen, then your faith is worthless and you're still in your sins. What the Apostle Paul was saying, if Jesus Christ was not actually literally raised from the dead, then what we believe is foolishness and we just better, you know, just pass out Easter eggs and bunnies at Easter instead of celebrating the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Well, I know and believe that Jesus was raised from the dead, not just because I read it in a book, but God watches over his word to perform it. That's how I know. Amen? He said that believers shall lay hands on the sick and they'll get healed. They'll get well. Amen? They'll recover. His word is true. Hallelujah. You know, maybe you might be in here and you're like Susie. You're thinking there's some sort of barrier, boundary between you and God or receiving from God. There is no barrier or boundary because the blood of Jesus covers you. The Bible says in 1 John 1:9, if we confess our sins, he is faithful and just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. There's something beautiful about just surrendering to God. Acts 3:19 says, repent then and turn to God that your sins may be wiped out, that times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord. Amen? Amen. Can I get an amen? Amen? I think I already got one, didn't I? Amen. I'm going to share one more testimony with you, and then we're going to release the healing power of God, and we're going to see people get healed. This next testimony I want to share with you is when I was a young boy, about 6 years old, I had this cat by the name of Crystal. It was a pure white cat. I love cats, grew up with cats. I like dogs too, but I love cats, and this particular cat was super nice. I mean, my dad could like roll him up in a basketball and shoot baskets with him, and he wouldn't try to claw you or bite you or anything. I mean, that's maybe a little bit of an exaggeration, but what he would do, he could take and flip him like this and flip him on his back, and just a nice cat. And so I was 6 years old, and Crystal was my good buddy as a six-year-old little boy. And you know how cats are, especially if they're an outside cat. Sometimes they like to go off and go on hunting trips to get birds or mice or whatever. And Crystal had been gone, a few days. And I heard my parents talking, like, I hope, you know, he comes back. I hope a dog didn't get him or something like that. And so I was worried and upset about my cat. So he finally came back, and I was so overjoyed that he was back and he was all right that I thought I needed to figure out a way to make sure that he would never go away again and never get lost again. So I found a rope in our yard, and I thought, I'm going to make him a leash so he can be like the neighbor's dogs and he just can't get away and he'll always be here so I can pet him whenever I want to. And so I didn't know really how to make a leash. What I ended up making was a slip knot. And so I put that around his neck, and I was leading him around like he was a dog. Then my friend Franklin yelled at me from across the street, and he said, hey, come over here and play with the Hot Wheels cars in the dirt. We love doing the NASCAR thing in the dirt. And so I tied the other end of the rope up to one of the balusters on the deck, and I went over to play with my friend Franklin. And when I came back, I opened the gate and I saw that Crystal had tried to get free. He jumped off the side of the deck and he was just hanging there with his tongue out. And I just stood there frozen. I was bawling and crying. And my mom heard me from inside the house, and she opened the door and she saw me bawling my head off. And then she looked at Crystal and she saw Crystal hanging there dead as a doornail with his tongue out. Hung, and then she went over to try to work the rope off of his neck. It took her a few minutes just to get the rope off of his neck. And then I went and I hid myself in my closet because I learned in Sunday school that we needed to pray in our prayer closet. So I went into my closet where we keep our clothes and shoes. And I went in there and I prayed to God and I said, God, if you'll just save my cat, if you'll just heal my cat, I'll do anything you want me to do for the rest of my life. And that's why I'm here today. Amen. So I came out and my mom's still praying over him and she said, Jason, go inside and get the oil, get the cooking oil. So the Bible says that you can anoint the sick with oil in the name of the Lord and the prayer of faith shall save the sick. Amen. So she got oil and anointed him, she asked me to get the oil and I came out with this big tub that said Crisco on it. She said, no, not the lard, the vegetable oil. So I went back in and I got the vegetable oil and she started praying in tongues over Crystal, really kind of like Pentecostal loud. And I'm just standing there thinking, oh my goodness, Mom, the neighbors are going to think you're crazy. There was neighbors across the street working on their deck and I know that they could hear her praying in tongues. But you know what happened? After a few minutes, Crystal started to breathe. And then she actually picked him up by the torso and made him walk, and then he started to walk. And then this is kind of the gross part, but that you know when a body dies, the bowels relax. Let's just say that Crystal fertilized the lawn about 3 times in a row that day. He got raised from the dead, and he also got a good colon cleanse. No. Glory to God. But hey, you know, the Bible says in Deuteronomy that he'll bless our livestock, that he'll even heal our livestock. That's one of the things that we've been redeemed from under the curse of the law is our animals to be healed. Hallelujah. Can I get an amen? Everybody say, if he healed Crystal, if he raised Crystal from the dead, then he'll heal me. Everybody say, when hands are laid upon me, the healing power of God will go into my body and I'll be healed. Now I want you to lift your hands up, look at your hands, say, the healing power of God is in my hands. The Bible says, I shall lay hands on the sick and they'll be healed. Amen. Now, I don't know what situation you find yourself in this morning, what desperate situation you find yourself in, but whatever that is, that situation does not have to determine your destination. You don't have to stay there. Just like the woman with the issue of blood, you can say to yourself, I'm going to get up and I'm going to touch the hem of his garment. I'm going to receive from what God has for me today. So I would invite you to bow your heads and close your eyes. And I want you to petition God for what it is you need from him today. The Bible says that you have not because you ask not. So I want you just to do business with God and just talk to him and say, God, you know, I need healing in my body. I need deliverance in my mind. Or maybe I need a financial breakthrough. God can do it. Amen. Open your heart to him and just let him receive from him. Let him bless you this morning. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. We could go ahead and have a little bit of background music if that'd be okay. Thank you, Father God. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Now, if you're in this place this morning and you have a pain or a sickness in your physical body, I want you to just slip your hand up. I see that hand. I see that hand. I see that hand. I see that hand. That hand. Many hands up going all over the room that people have a pain or a sickness or something going on in their body where they need healing. The healing power of God is here this morning to meet you right where you're at. His love is towards you. His grace and His mercy is towards you. The Bible says the mercies of the Lord are brand new every morning. So if you had your hand up, I want you to go ahead and slip it up again and keep it up. Now I'd like everybody just to open their eyes as you keep your hands up. Open your eyes. And I want you to look around the room and see these people who have their hands up saying that they need prayer for healing in their physical body. As we said this morning, believers shall lay hands on the sick and the sick shall recover. So I want you to find somebody. So those of you who don't have your hand up, go find somebody that does have their hand up. And you know, maybe you're sitting next to somebody and you both have your hands up. Just put your hands on each other. Amen. So you can go ahead and get up out of your seat and go find somebody. Find somebody, and I want you to put your hand on them. We're going to pray for one another together. All together as a group, we're going to pray, and the healing power of God's going to flow, and people are going to be healed and set free as we pray. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God said in His word that believers shall lay hands on the sick. He said that if you believe in Him, you would do the works that He did and even greater works. You've been called, appointed, anointed, and commissioned to do the works of Jesus. So right now, let's pray together. I want you to repeat after me. Just say, right now, in Jesus' name, pain, sickness, disease, I command you to go now. In Jesus' name. Now I want you to move your body. Do what you couldn't do before. If you had pain in your back, pain in your shoulders, pain in your neck, your stomach, whatever, do something you couldn't do before without pain. Maybe you need to stand up and bend over. Whatever it is, test it out. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Hallelujah. Praise God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise God. Yeah. All right, we're going to do that again. Now, if you're sitting here, and I want everybody to raise their hand. Raise your hand if you were just prayed for and you felt something change in your body. You felt the pain leave. Something's different. You know, just like the woman with the issue of blood, that, man, I received my healing. That pain's gone. Just go ahead and slip your hand up. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Any more hands? 6. It just changed right there. 6. Who else? Who else got their hand up? 7 right there. Amen. Anybody else? You felt something change in your body. Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Sister, can you come up here? Praise God. I'd just like for you to share with the congregation what happened, what God did for you.
Bizarre.
Yeah.
Nothing's too little. Nothing's too little. And in my mind, I'm like, you know, there's so many people out there that need big healings. You know, Pastor always says, nothing's too little for God. And I work in a library. I reached back this week and kind of pulled a muscle. And it's just like, you know, kind of digging at me all week. And I thought, oh, I'll just deal with it. Yeah. I'll just go through it. And every time you said that we had the power in our hands, that God has given us the power to do even the little things. I believe that. I do believe that. And I looked at my husband and I looked at him and he's laying hands on me, and I thought to myself, we should do this more often as a couple.
Yeah.
We should be doing this more often. And I accepted it. And it was a little thing, but it's a huge thing.
Yeah. So what happened? You had pain in your back.
Pain in my back.
Where at?
Right back here.
Right here. And how long? It, been
it just happened this week.
So it had been hurting ever since you got injured.
Yep.
How would you describe the pain? On a scale of 1 to 10.
Oh, on a scale?
Yeah.
Oh, it was probably, because I've done this before, it probably an 8 it out of a 10.
So it was comfortable at all.
It's not comfortable because you're always using.
Bothering you.
Yes.
So he laid hands on you, and what happened?
Then it was instantly gone.
Just boom, just boom, like that.
Gone.
Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Who else? You raise your hand. We had other people raising their hands. Something changed in your body. You testify that God healed you. Yeah, what happened, sister? Amen. Yeah, what happened? What changed in your body?
Well, this week I had to put a protection order against my husband because he hurt me.
Okay.
And all week I have been scared and jumpy about everything, and he did hurt me physically also.
Okay.
But a lot of it is spiritually and emotionally.
Sure.
So anyways, he's gone. I've been carrying them burdens and fear. My back is slightly hurt. It's still a little sore, but what happened was the fear left me.
Yeah.
And I feel stronger and lighter.
Good. Well, you know God loves you, right?
Yes.
Does your back hurt right now?
Not right now while I'm talking.
Not right now while you're talking.
No, so I think the fear must have taken over.
Yeah, so
of talking in public.
Yeah. Did somebody come over and pray for you and the pain left your back? Is that what happened?
People have been praying for me. I had almost died 3 times this year.
Yeah.
And I was very sick, and this whole congregation has been praying for me.
Amen.
And I'm here today.
Praise God. So you have no more pain in your back, is that right?
Right now, no.
It's all gone.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody say, isn't Jesus wonderful? Amen. Who else? Raise your hand. Something happened. Something changed in your body you'd like to share. Anybody else? We had some more hands up. You know, a testimony is permission for a repeat, right?
Yeah.
Amen. Glory to God. Yeah, what happened, sister?
That feels weird. You call me sister. Anyway, I have been standing in recovery for my knees, and because I received healing, and I know that I did. So I've been standing in that, and right now it's just a nice, cool gel feeling.
Yeah. Praise God. So before you were prayed for, were your knees in pain before you were prayed for this morning?
They were aching.
Your knees were aching. How would you describe that pain, that aching in your knees that you came into church with? Is that right?
Yeah.
How would you describe that aching?
It was probably a 4.
It was a 4. And is that like kind of like a constant thing that it never goes away, or wakes you up at night and it's always hurting throughout the day? So this is not normal for you to be sitting here without pain in your knees. Is that right? And then when did it leave?
When we all gathered and held hands and prayed.
So when someone prayed for you and laid hands on you, did it just instantly leave?
I wouldn't call it instant, but it was like it started and then it just, the cooling feeling took over.
Yeah. So within maybe a few seconds or something.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's instant enough for me, right? Amen. That's better than the microwave. Glory to God. Woo! Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. God is good, isn't he? Who else would like to share? Yeah, brother. Amen. Come on up here. Yeah. Yes.
Now, we've been taught in this church, do not accept an evil report.
Yeah.
Now, I was given an evil report, and I told my wife, I said, I do not accept it. And in by faith, I could feel I'm not having issues with any blood sugar or anything like that anymore. I felt it leave my body as they laid hands on me.
Good. Amen. Amen. Hold on. Another dose of the Holy Ghost is always good. Amen. I just felt it. We thank you, Father, right now in the name of Jesus. From the top of his head to the soles of his feet and everywhere in between. I curse diabetes and the cause of it, and I tell it to go now in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, that his blood sugar is normal. Lord, I thank you that he'll have a clean bill of health from the doctor, a good, clean report from the doctor. Ha, 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 ha. Thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Anybody? Yeah. What's going
on? Since my better half came up here. So if you didn't hear that, since my better half came up here,
good.
I better come
That's
up here.
That's a good wife.
So, yes, my husband and I have both been struck with a diagnosis of some sort recently. So we've been standing in faith together, for both of our diagnoses that we're not accepting. I was diagnosed with Hashimoto's disease, or I don't even know if I said that right. Yeah. There is a medical technical term that don't ask me to say that, I don't know. But my thyroid is large. It was actually a very big surprise diagnosis for me. I wasn't expecting it, whatever. But there it was. And so like I said, we've been standing in faith that we're not accepting that and learning how to do that together. And so my thyroid, if I put my head back, I will gag. My thyroid was enlarged. And in fact, even this morning, I've actually had a pretty bad gag reflex for a long time. And you just think, oh, well, you know, I don't know, it comes with age. Or in fact, a lot of the symptoms I was having, I just figured I was getting old, and old getting old sucks, right? That's not the case. So wisdom comes with age, so remember that. but even this morning, my daughter, I was brushing my teeth, and I was gagging. And she's like, Mom, seriously, stop it. And I'm like, you know what's funny is I don't think I can control it, because when I brush my teeth or even if I touch my thyroid, I will gag. And that's part of it. And I do have I still have a rash on my body right now, but that is leaving. And so as our brother and sister in Christ have, and my children and my husband laid hands on us today, I can feel the thyroid shrinking. I didn't have that gaggy, automatic, sitting there, gaggy feeling.
Praise God. All right, hold on. Sarah, come up here. Another dose. Go ahead and put your hand on her right there. In Jesus' name, right now, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Father God, for that disease that I can't pronounce the name of it. You know what it is, Lord. We thank you, Father, that she's healed by the stripes of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, for a good report from the doctor. We thank you that that thyroid is shrinking back to normal size. And we curse that rash and we tell it to go in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, for your healing power working in her body. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Whew. Glory to God. Man, felt the power of God go into you right there. Hallelujah. Glory to God. That's awesome. She felt her thyroid shrinking. Isn't that awesome? Praise God. Anybody else want to share? Yeah. You want me to come to you? I'll come to you. Or you can come up here. Come on. Why not? Yeah. Man, God is good, isn't he? Man, what's your name?
Pam.
Pam? Nice to meet you. My name's Jason.
Nice to meet you, too. All right. Well, I was starting to have trouble this week with in my eye. It was hurting. I'd get pain. And so I prayed, and then it come back, and I prayed, and I said, you get the heck out of here now.
Yeah.
It took a while, and it's just been trying to come back still. Well, today, my eye is just, I don't feel a thing. I mean, well,
yeah.
There's no pain.
Praise God.
Yeah. And that's,
praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Now, was it hurting when you came in?
No, it wasn't.
Okay.
It wasn't, but you can tell the eyes are watering right now.
Yeah.
They've been.
Yeah, right now. We thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for your healing power going into her eyes. Right now, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Eyes be made whole. Now, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for it. There it goes. There it goes. Man, I feel the healing power of God going into your body right now. There it goes. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Amen. Keep thanking God you're healed. Amen. Yeah, that's all right. Amen. Thank you so much. Yeah. God bless you. Praise the Lord. Now, if you're in here this morning and you've never made Jesus the Lord of your life, or maybe, you know, you haven't been living for the Lord, been away from the Lord, maybe it's been a while since you've been to church, I just ask everybody to bow their heads and close their eyes. I want to give everybody here an opportunity to make Jesus Christ the Lord of their life. And if you could say to yourself that, you know what, maybe I need to rededicate my life to Jesus. Maybe I've been away from Jesus, and I want the real Jesus. I want his love. I want his power. I want his joy and peace in my life. I just ask you to slip your hand up. Just go ahead and slip your hand up right now. See that hand? You need Jesus in your life. Amen. All right, let's pray together. And I invite everybody to pray this prayer. And if you pray this prayer and you mean it, you're sincere about it in your heart. The Bible says that you can know for sure that you're going to heaven. You can have a relationship with him. And I promise you, it'll be the best decision that you've ever made. The very best decision that you've ever made. God can bring peace and joy to you. Amen. Amen. Totally change your life for the good. Everybody pray this prayer together. Say, Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for loving me. Thank you for sending your son Jesus to die on the cross for my sins. Jesus, I ask you to come into my heart and be my Lord and my Savior. And I promise to live for you. And I'm not afraid to live for you, Jesus. Because I know you always want the best for me. I believe that you are the Son of God. And that you died on the cross for my sin. And you rose from the dead. And you are my Lord. Amen. Now, if you prayed that prayer, the Bible says you've passed from death to life, and Jesus lives in you, the Spirit of God lives in you, and you're saved, amen. Can we rejoice? We had folks pray, amen. Hallelujah! Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Now, if you're in this place and you still have some sort of pain or something going on in your physical body, I want to invite everyone to come on up here. If you still would like prayer for something, you need prayer for anything, I'd advise you to come up here and we can just form a line and we'll minister to you. Amen. And you can just come on, brother. Amen. If anybody else needs prayer for anything, just come on up here. Hallelujah. Yeah. Amen. Hey, brother, what can I do for you? Thank you, Father. Father God, we just thank you for our dear brother. Lord, we thank you that your healing power is working in his body right now. Father God, I'm reminded of your word, Father God, of the 10 lepers, where Jesus said to him, go show yourself to the priest. And the Bible says that they were healed as they went. That's the modern day equivalent of someone saying, go show yourself to the doctor. Because they had to check them out and see if they were healed of their leprosy. And just like Jesus told the 10 lepers, go show yourself to the priest, go show yourself to the doctor, and have them test the nerve endings and see that life has been restored to those, and health and circulation is being renewed and restored to all the different parts of your body. Hallelujah. And Father, we thank you that he will be able to walk. We thank you that as strength is restored unto his legs and unto his back and unto his whole body, that he's going to walk. We thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name. And Lord, we thank you for that healing power that's working right now in his physical body, restoring all the electrical connections and nerve endings. And we thank you, Father, for it. And Lord, I'm just going to place my faith in agreement with him, Father, that he's going to make exponential progress in his physical therapy. We thank you, Father, for it. And that it'll be supernatural, exponential. We thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Can everybody say amen?
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Can everybody say God is good? You need, yes. Yeah. Yeah. Hold on one second. Where's the mic? Yeah. Yes. Yes. So, tell me what was going on again.
Well, I fell off a bike 2 years ago.
Yeah.
Really hurt my spine bad.
Yeah.
Break anything.
Uh-huh.
But when you were praying for Ralph, things went through me because I accepted. I was praying for his healing.
Yeah.
Planting a seed faith.
Yes.
Yes. I'm being healed.
Praise God. So what's happening with your hands? What's going on here?
I have a healing ministry.
Yes.
My hands can do for the anointing.
Yes, amen. What's going on with your back? You have a pain right there?
On the side. Well, I have a tilted pelvis from birth.
Yeah.
So when I hit it, but...
Yeah. Would you like that pain to leave? How bad would you rate the pain in your back?
Oh, I couldn't get out of bed this morning.
How bad does it hurt right now?
It's getting better because Debbie prayed too. Started, but...
Yeah.
When I was feeling for his healing.
Yeah. How would you rate the pain right now in your back?
A 2, maybe.
A 2? How would you like that just to be all the way gone right
amen,
now?
Jesus.
Would that be all right? All right, I'm going to put my hand on your back. The healing power of God's going to go through your back, and that's just going to leave. So you can feel the level 2 pain. It's going to go to 0. How is that? All right? All right, right now, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name, back pain and the cause of it, I curse you. And I command you to go now in Jesus' name. There it goes. Ooh, glory to God. There it goes. Thank you, Father. There it goes. Man, I feel the healing power of God going into your back right now. Do you feel that? Shoo, glory to God. Go ahead and twist your back. Bend over. How's that? Where's the pain at?
1.
A 1? Okay, we
I'm
went from...
tingling.
Tingling up your spine.
See, I hit so hard that my nerves are tingling.
first.
Yeah. All right. Well, we can fix those nerves too. How about that? Right now, in Jesus' name, tingling sensation, I command you to go now in Jesus' name. All pain in the back, I command you to go now, right now, in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, for it. Go ahead and twist. Bend. How's that? Yeah, amen. Is it better? Where's the pain at? Right now, in Jesus' name, we thank you, Father, for it. Right now, hallelujah.
Yes, thank you.
If God can take a little, He can take a lot. Amen. Right now, in the name of Jesus, every last bit of pain, I tell you to go now. In Jesus' name.
It's
hallelujah.
Going.
Huh?
It's going.
It's going?
Yeah, thank you.
Hallelujah.
He's restored. Thank you.
Completely gone now in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Say this with me. Say right now.
Right now.
Pain?
Pain.
I command you to leave.
Command you to leave.
Now.
Now.
In Jesus' name. Now go ahead and twist your back again. Go ahead and bend. Better?
Yep.
Healed? Amen. Amen. Love you. Appreciate you. Give me a high five. All right. You keep thanking God you're healed. Amen. Everybody say, God is good.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time.
Yep. Amen. Amen. Everybody, raise your hand again. You felt something change in your body. You were prayed for, whether I laid hands on you or somebody else laid hands on you. You had pain and you just felt it change. Go, everybody, lift your hands up. You felt it change. Now look around. Look at all these hands. Isn't that awesome? Amen. I'm going to give one more invitation. If there's anybody else here, you'd like prayer for something, you come up here and I'll pray for you. If not, then that means we got everybody. Amen. Amen. If we could turn the music up just a little bit, maybe have a little bit faster, that'd be great. Hallelujah.
Physical issues, musculoskeletal. I also have some prostate things, which we're about to tell right now.
They're sure. Fixed. Yeah. So what's going on, physical things?
Well, this arm.
Something you could do to make it hurt?
Yeah.
Every time you squeeze your hand, would you like that to leave? All right, let's do it right now in the name of Jesus. You ready? All right, Father, we thank you. I'm going to put my hands, healing power of God, here it goes. Thank you, Father. Right now in Jesus' name. Lord, I thank you for this man. I thank you that you love him. I thank you that you care about him. I thank you that you're always for him and never against him. I thank you that you remove his sin as far as the east is from the west. Thank you for pouring your love out on him, Father. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for your healing power, your delivering power, your saving power, washing through him. In Jesus' name. There it goes, man. Feel the healing power of God going into your arm right now. You feel that? How is that?
It's improved.
Improved? How much improved?
About
90%. So just a second ago, you squeezed that, and it was considerably more painful to do that.
Yep.
And now it's just practically not even there. Is that what you're saying?
Yes, well, a quarter of what it was.
Quarter of what it was. All right, well, let's just get it all the way gone. All right. You know, there's a story in the Bible where Jesus prayed for a blind man twice. The first time he prayed for him, he said, "What do you see?" He said, "I see men walking as trees." Jesus prayed for him a second time. He said, "What do you see?" He said, "I see all men clearly." It's like, oh, we'll just go ahead and get it all the way. Amen. Woo! Thank you, Jesus.
right now, in Jesus' name, all pain and the cause of it, muscle soreness, stiffness, damage to the tendons or the ligaments, inflammation. Man, my hands are hot, dude. Jeez. Glory to God. Go in the name of Jesus. Go ahead and move your hand. Thank you, Father. How is that?
It's good.
It's good? All gone?
Just feel like not completely normal, but like not painful.
It's not painful. All right. One more time. Thank you, Father, for it. Right now, in the name of Jesus. Arm, we command you to be made normal now in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father, for it. Pain and the cause of it, we tell you to go now in Jesus' name. It's working. It's working. Thank you, Jesus. There it goes. There it goes. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Right now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. I know God just wants, sometimes I just do weird stuff with people. In the name of Jesus. It's not weird. It's the healing power of God. In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Go ahead and do it again. How's that? Is that good?
Yeah,
is that great. Awesome? Amen. Amen. Now, what else that you...
I'm impressed.
Yeah. All right, right now, in the name of Jesus, I speak to that prostate and I command you to be a normal size. Right now, in the name of Jesus, be whole. Now, in Jesus' name. No more issues or complications with anything. We thank you, Father, for it. Lord, we thank you that he'll have a clean bill of health concerning this issue from his doctor. And we thank you, Father God, that he's feeling within his body that this is gone. We thank you for it right now. Thank you for your healing power going, working in his body. Now, in Jesus' name, amen. 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 Love you, brother. Amen. Yeah, amen. Pray for you, my brother.
I have neuropathy in my hands and feet and my legs.
Yeah.
It's hard to stand.
Yeah. Would you like that to leave?
Yes.
All right. I'm gonna pray for you. That neuropathy is gonna leave right now. In Jesus' name. Right now, neuropathy, tingling, numbness. I command you to go now. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for it. Go in the name of Jesus. Right now, in Jesus' name. We thank you, Father. Go ahead and move your hands. Do some, how's that feel? Where's it at?
They still tingle.
Yeah. Thank you, Father, for it. Right now, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, for it. Right now, neuropathy. I command you to go now in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father, right now in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Father God. There it goes. There it goes. Right now, every last bit of tingling, numbness, I command you to leave now in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. How you doing, brother? We thank you that your healing power is working in this dear brother's body. We thank you that your healing power is working, 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 working. We thank you, Lord, for it. In Jesus' name. I want you to continue just to thank God and praise God that you're healed. Continue to thank him that his healing power is working in your body. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I love you, brother. Can I give you a hug?
Love you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Would it be possible to get just some music, maybe a little bit more upbeat? It'd be good. Okay.
She was diagnosed with hydrocephalus. She has a VA shunt, and with her prematurity comes a lot of medical things.
Yeah.
And we are standing in belief for her head and her brain to be fully functional.
Yes.
For her eyes to be uncrossed, for her nerves in this arm to come alive again.
Yes.
For the rest of her body Amen. To keep growing.
Amen. We're going to agree with you. Come on, Sarah. Father God, we just thank you for this dear child here right now. In Jesus' name. Lord, we thank you that your healing power is working in her body. We speak to her eyes, every part of her body. We tell it to be healed and whole. In the name of Jesus, hydrocephalus, we curse you. And we command you to go in the name of Jesus. Lord, we decree and declare that she will develop normally, in Jesus' name, we thank you that by the stripes of Jesus, she is healed and whole. In Jesus' name, thank you, Father God, for it. In Jesus' name, hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Father God, we just pray for Mom, Lord. We thank you for your strength, Father God, for your grace and your goodness flowing through her life. We thank you, Lord, for helping her, Father God, strengthening her. We pray that she would be encouraged. Continue to thank you and praise you that your healing power is working in her baby's body. We thank you, Father, for it. In Jesus' name. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Amen. Everybody say, isn't Jesus wonderful? Praise God. There's nobody else. Imagine we're getting close to closing time. I would like to make mention real quick of our book table. My son DJ, go ahead and stand up, DJ. He's going to be back at the book table, and we've got some really great books here. This one is How You Can Be Led by the Spirit of God by Brother Kenneth Hagin. Wonderful book. I've read that about 8 times and just love it. We've got another one called The Love, the Way to Victory. The Bible says that love never fails. Yeah. So that would be a wonderful book to get. And just a lot of stuff back there that would really help you out. This one's called Change Your Life for Good, and this was kind of birthed out of a time in my life where, you know, I'd made some mistakes, and I kind of felt guilty about it, and I was having a hard time stepping into who God had called me to be because of it. The devil was trying to keep me beat down, so I just started to get into the in him scriptures of who we are in Christ. And, you know, when you mess up sometimes, the devil can make you feel bad about yourself, and I'd wake up in the morning and look at myself, oh, there's that loser again. But then I started to renew my mind to the Word of God. With about 6 months of listening to this on a daily basis, I woke up in the morning and I saw, man, I love what I'm looking at. and I felt, I didn't just know that the Bible says I'm the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. I felt it too in my heart and in my mind. And the Bible says you're transformed by the renewing of your mind. So that'd be a good one. The CDs are $4 each, or you can get 2 for $7. And we also have this little thumb drive. It's got 30 of my best messages on there for $30. So $1 a message, really good deal. If you're a bargain hunter, that's for you. Amen. And I'm going to have some of these cards back at the book table. You can take this to my website, and I've got a four-part message called Divine, or called Healing Rescue. It's a four-part message, Divine Health and Healing Parts 1 and 2, Divine Health and Healing Confessions, and then the next one is How to Always Receive What You Need from God. So you can go to my website, and this will help you receive healing, help you maintain the healing that you receive today. Amen. You know, you got to maintain stuff if you want it to keep running right. Amen. You got to change the oil in your car, maintain it, and this will help you do that as well. So those will be free at the book table. If you would like one of those, you can grab one. If you would like one, you could also just be at the book table. How about that? So, DJ, I'm going to give you those, and just give them to anybody who wants them at the book table. And sorry, I'm a long-winded preacher. Turn it over to you. Amen.
Praise God. Well, when he's got one shot, we've got to give him his liberty to do so. So we're going to go ahead and receive our offering this morning. And keep in mind that tonight, too, Jason's going to be ministering to the youth. And that starts at 5 o'clock. And so that's youth meeting at 5. And so he did evangelism training, ministry today, and then he's doing youth tonight, so we want to be able to bless him. So this is regular tithes and offerings. And then when you're designating toward his ministry, you can just put Jason Fath in the memo portion of your check or at the appropriate place on an offering envelope. Let's pray and ask God to direct us. Father, we thank you so much that you brought the gift of God to us. And we thank you for that you ministered to our spirit, soul, and body. We thank you, Lord, now that we can bless them back. Thank you, Lord, for directing us in this offering as you'd have us to do. Thank you, Lord, for grace to give now in Jesus' name. And everybody agree to that said? Amen. If you make out a check this morning, make it out to Eternity Church or Market EC, and then in the memo portion you can put Jason Fath and whatever portion that God leads you to give toward his ministry. If you're giving cash, you want a tax-deductible receipt, raise your hand while the ushers give you an envelope. Just keep your hand up till they get to you. Amen. Glory to God. We're very, very thankful for the Fath family being with us and for ministering to us and helping us. Glory to God. Encouraging us, bringing healing and wholeness to us. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Anybody else need an envelope? All right, let's all stand then. Let's present our tithes and offerings to him, to God, because we're not giving to a person or to an organization, but we're giving to God. Say it out loud. Say, Heavenly Father, bring my tithes. I give my offerings according to your word. I'm acting on your word. I believe your word. I believe I can't outgive you. So as I give, it is given back to me, good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. I have more than enough. Abundance is coming to me. The blessings of God are coming upon me and chasing me down. In Jesus' name, amen.